Spandana, co-pilot is Sonal and crew member is Indrani. Over to you, Spandana.
Hello, everyone. So, do you remember which country we are visiting today?
Turkey, ma'am.
Correct. Okay. So, today we are seeing Turkey. And anyone have any guesses? What is the capital of Turkey? See, let's see. It's called as Ankara is the capital of Turkey. Do you see the map over here of Turkey? So Turkey is officially known as Republic of Turkey. And it shares land borders with Greece and Bulgaria in the northwest region. And Mediterranean Sea in the south. Here you can see it properly. And Black Sea is in the north of Turkey. President name is called as Recep Tayyip Erdogan. And population is 84.3 million in according to 2020 list. So let's see about the capital city, that is Ankara. It's historically known as Angora or Ancira. It has a population of about 4.5 million. This city is very old and has many archaeological sites. That is, they have very prehistoric sites which are preserved today and are very well visited also. And this city's history can be traced till Bronze Age. Ankara was officially named Turkey's capital in 1923. So we'll go to the next slide. So the flag of Turkey, this is often called as Bayrak or the red flag. It is referred as Al Sankar or the red banner in the national anthem. This has a red background and crescent, moon and star on the flag. And it is usually seen in state institution or schools and ministries. And the width to length ratio of the flag is 2:3. It has a very unique story about this. Nobody knows the origin of why this flag has crescent, moon and a star. Few say because there are many Islam religion people, they have crescent, moon and star. And few say it is because some king saw the crescent, moon and star when he was going through somewhere. So that's why they have this. These are the signs. But still they are following this and red is the background color. So the language. Official language is Turkish. More than 90% of the population has Turkish as their first language. Other languages spoken are Kurdish, Arabic and Circassian. Turkish is also referred to as Istanbul Turkish and it is the national language of Turkey. Here in the pie chart, you can see, right, more than 90% of the people, red color is shown as Turkish language spoken by the people. And few other languages are there over here. So the currency is called as Turkish New Lira, which is the national currency of Turkey. And one Turkish lira is subdivided into 100 kuros. So any of you have any idea how much does one Turkish New Lira equal to in Indian rupees? Does any of you know? It's one Turkish lira is equal to 8.55 Indian rupees. So government, it is a united unitary government as a parliamentary of the Democratic Republic known as Republic of Turkey. This is the president of Turkey. As I told you before, his name is Recep Tayyip Erdogan. So let's see the religion. Islam is the largest followed religion in Turkey. Almost more than 95% of the people in Turkey follow Islam religion. And other religion found are Christianity, Judaism, and also few people consider themselves no religion also. So this is the national animal. It is called as gray wolf. And Canis lupus is the scientific name of gray wolf. And do you know why they have kept gray wolf as their national animal? Because according to their story, they believe that ancient Turks were raised by wolves like their own offspring. And mystic gray wolf came and helped them to conquer everything during a very dark time, that is chilling winters they had. That's why they have kept gray wolf as their national animal. There were many gray wolves before in Turkey, but now a little bit endangered. So they have started preserving the gray wolves, and now they have very good number of it. So the national flower is called as tulip. Tulip is the national flower. National sport is the oil wrestling. This tradition can be marked back to thousands of years. Kirkpinar annual festival in Edirne in Western Turkey is dedicated to this activity, and thousands of foreigners and people across the country come to visit this oil wrestling competition and also to participate in it. It was popularized during the rule of Ottomans. There was a rule of Ottomans during in the Turkish history, and during this, two soldiers fought till death in the oil wrestling competition. That's why it became very popular, but now obviously they can't do that, right? That's why now they have updated the rules, and it is very culturally significant and has been recognized by UNESCO's representative lists of intangible cultural heritage of humanity in 2010. Now there is a time limit of 45 minutes and points to be gained to win the match. So in this oil wrestling competition, they have to wear a certain kind of pants, that is leather pants, which are given to them. And they put olive oil over them before fighting. So before looking at the culture, let's see a video of the basic introduction of Turkey. Culture of Turkey is very diverse and combination of various cultures like Eastern Mediterranean culture, West Asia, Central Asia, Middle East, and also some European culture. So they have very diverse culture, which is multicultural mix. And many of the traditions were put together during the Ottoman Empire with multi-religious and multi-ethnic traditions. So let's see. Turkish cuisine. Fusion of Mediterranean, Balkan, and Middle Eastern, Central Asian, and Eastern European cuisine is Turkish cuisine. Turkish cuisine is like across the country, there are many cuisines you can see. So there is no such thing as national cuisine. And they implement many traditional Turkic elements and spices. Few parts of Turkey are influenced by Ottomans. So use of lighter spices and have preference for rice and vegetables. And near the Black Sea region, it is famous for fish items. And Southeast region is famous for kebabs and dough-based desserts. I'll show you a few of the food they have. So this is called as baklava. It is a dough-based dessert. And this is a shish kebab. This is a Turkish side of pizza. It is called as pide. And this is a like a snack, chat kind of thing, kumpir. What we see here like pani puri, sev puri, no, they have kumpir. And it is instead of puri, they have a boiled potato on which they have different kind of toppings. And this is called as koftes. So the traditional clothes. Traditional clothes also vary according to region, but from Ottoman era, traditional dress still that can be seen today in Turkey is for females, it's salwar. It is a baggy trousers usually worn with the upper garments of various styles. And for men, it's jubba. It is a loose coat over a salwar. But there are very many different kind of traditional clothes differing according to the region. That's why I'm showing you these pictures. See how different and varied it is. It is different across the regions. So the next one we are seeing is Turkish folk dance. Since Turkish culture is very diverse, there are many folk dances in Turkey varying according to the region. Most of the dances are called are line dances, which reflect each region's culture, their own sounds, their own music, their cultural stories and history. The bar is one kind of a dance, which is from Erzurum province. And the hale is the another folk dance of east and southwest. The horon is of Black Sea region and many more. See, this is one kind of a dance called as horon dance. And this is called as hale dance. So we'll see the national airline of Turkey. Turkish airline is a national carrier and also the country's largest airline. It has both domestic and international service. It serves more than 315 destinations, and this airline serves more destinations non-stop from single airport across the world. It is one of the very famous airline. And even its cargo division serves up to 82 destinations. See, this is the Turkish airline. And can you see the logo over here with the red background and white blues? I'll tell you the story about it. The motto of Turkish airline is called as widen your world. And the slogan also says discover the potential Turkey. So the logo has white wild goose in white with the red background. So the basically the wild goose is the known as world's highest flying bird. That's why they are depicting it as Turkish Airlines also, which is it also flies very high. So places to visit in Turkey. Turkey is very famous for tourism. So there are many tourist attractions and it is famous for historical sites, seaside resorts and places near Aegean and Mediterranean Sea. It was ranked world's top 6th most popular tourist place as there were 51 million foreign visitors in 2019 alone. This is the first place which I'm showing you, Hagia Sophia, or it is also called as Hagia Sophia. It is considered as one of the most beautiful buildings in the world. This is considered as one of the must-see sites in Turkey. It is present in Istanbul. Hagia Sophia means holy wisdom. It is a late antique place of worship designed by Greek geometers. It was originally built as a church by one of the monarchs who was there in Turkey. And then after the invasion happened, it was turned into a mosque. Now it is declared as a museum. It has a very rich history, innovative architecture, and has a religious importance. See the inside of the Hagia Sophia, it's very beautiful. This is a place where, because it has a rich history, religious history, here you can see even Christian statues like the statue of Mary and also Islam kind of architectures. So the next one is called as Pamukkale. It is a natural wonder of Turkey. Pamukkale means white castle in India, in English. It looks like out of place snowfield in the green landscape. It is a carbonate mineral left by the flowing of thermal spring water. So it is a geothermal area. The carbonated mineral, whatever is left by the spring water over there, it has become like this and it has become a natural wonder. So people across the country and outside of the country come here to visit regularly. It is located in Aegean region. There are also well-preserved Roman ruins and museums nearby. And it is now declared as UNESCO World Heritage Site. I'll show you a few of the beautiful pictures of Pamukkale. See, here people can go visit and go to the water also. This is a very beautiful site and it is called as Mount Nemrut. It is also known as Mysterious Mountain. It is top sightseeing site in the eastern Turkey. It is a mountain and is a famous for broken mammoth statues. It is assumed to be a royal tomb from 1st century BC. It is one of the highest mountain peaks of Taurus Mountain. These statues show the story and glory of King Antiochus and also of the gods. So this is called as Mysterious Mountains because archaeologists have still not found the particular history, correct history and the reason why it is like however it is. The statues are over on the ground and these mammoth statues are there. They don't know how in that ancient time without the modern technology they have built this place. See this architecture over there. How beautiful it is. This is why it's called as a mysterious mountain. So the next one is Cappadocia. These are the beautiful rock valleys of Cappadocia. It is famously known as photographer's dream. They have wave-like rock and rippling hill crests. It is also known as world's top destination for hot air balloon ride. There are churches of Byzantine era and it is an important early Christian site. See the photos? Can you see the wave-like rocks and the hills over here? So this is why it's a very beautiful and all the photographers usually dream of going there and taking a photos. So with this, we come to an end. But before that, we will see one more video of the top places to visit in Turkey. Sonal, you can share the video.
Cleopatra Beach.
Yeah, it's beautiful, no?
Okay, so anybody want to present today? Yes, Shobhanita.
Yes, ma'am.
You want to present?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, wait. We are making you co-host. You can share your screen, Shobhanita.
Ma'am, 1 second. Namaste everyone to the Turkey tour. So the culture of Turkey. So here you can see the Turkey how they wear their dresses in Turkey, and you can see what type of food they eat and their shoes here. And I wanted to tell you the national sport, and it's also the fact, also known as Greece westering, in the considered to be a national sport. The westerners do douse themselves with olive oil before they take their opponent. The currency of Turkish is Turkish new lira. And this is the flag of Turkey. And the language they speak in Turkey is Turkish. And the food, I have been shown you here some food of Turkey. And the national animal of Turkey is gray wolf. And the national fruit of Turkey is sultan grapes.
Thank you, Shobhanita.
Thank you.
That was a very informative presentation.
Thank you, ma'am.
Okay. Ma'am? Yes, Kiona?
Tomorrow, what are we going to visit?
UAE.
Okay.
Ma'am, can you...
So, UAE is America, right?
United Arab Emirates, UAE.
Ma'am, can you repeat the country?
Because I have a PPT of America.
UAE.
Ma'am, my mom was born in UAE.
Oh, wow.
And ma'am, my Nana ji made a gurdwara there.
Okay. So you enjoyed our today's session?
Yes.
It is so beautiful, na? So that's all about our today's tour. Tomorrow we are going to visit UAE. So if you want to make any presentation, you can, or you can just search for some facts and you can share with us. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Bye. Take care.